हरे कृष्णा। श्री नरसिम्ह जयंती की जय। सो दिस नरसिम्ह लीला इज वेरी स्पेशल एंड वी कैन लर्न सो मेनी लेसन्स इन दिस फ्रॉम एवरी कैरेक्टर इन्वॉल्व इन दिस लीला। टेकिंग हिरण्यकशिपु'स कैरेक्टर, ही वॉज he is the dream fulfiller of all the materialist. What all a materialist want to achieve in his life, he did achieve everything in his life, but he was dissatisfied. If you see what all he achieved, described in Bhagavatam 7th canto 4th chapter, after his tapasya, he got a body made of gold. He conquered all the three worlds, and he made residence in Indra's Nandana Kanana. The building was made with rubies, corals, crystals, and his bed was like a white foam silk bedding. Hiranyakashipu. So he's more interested in gold and bed for sense gratification. And he had all the demigods, 33 crore demigods, except three, Brahma, Shiva and Vishnu. Brahma because he gave him booms, Shiva because he was powerful, and Vishnu because he was not visible. He spared the three of them. But all the rishis, even Narada Muni, as a part of Leela, he was glorifying Hiranyakashipu. And he was fully drunk. He was so immediately people who go for sense gratification, drinking wine is one of the highest gratification. And also he took all the shares of the demigods in oblations who were performed yagna for demigods. He took all the share. And he influenced the whole world, its functioning. He made a system that earth was forcefully supposed to give grains, no matter if there was tilling or no. But earth was forced to give grains. Cows were forced to give milk even though they didn't have calf. Oceans were forced to give gems. No one had to go into that. Ocean themselves have to provide gems at their shores. And mountains were his sporting place. Shaila Kridam. And Sarvarutushu Gunandrumaha. All trees and plants were forced to give flowers and fruits irrespective of the season. Seeing all this, one may feel, well, what do you need more? Everything you want is available. Before giving a boon, Brahma said, I'm giving you this, but you have to be careful, because it's not just receiving but even maintaining it. Varan yadyadi durlabha, Brahma says. Many a times, whatever we receive looks like a benediction but may can be a great curse. Like Nahusha, king became Indra, got an Indra position, but he misused it and ended up as a big curse and he became a snake. So it's very important how you receive your benedictions. So he changed the whole system. This is very much prevalent in present day world also, because so-called developed countries, they want to use all the resources. It is said in some senses that 65% of the resources are used by developed countries, and developing countries are in big numbers. Example, USA, it has 5% of the world's population but uses 25% of world resources. This is basically a Hiranyakashipu mentality. That's why, though he was very successful, but he was never satisfied. Natruptyad Ajitendriha, because his senses were not under control. So this is the problem. You may, for externally, pose to be very successful in the universe, most successful man, but that is tested by the element of satisfaction. So Hiranyakashipu was not satisfied. But if you see Prahlad Maharaj, his own son, we could see he was very satisfied, he was successful. Because success is rated not on the amount of wealth you acquire, but it has different factors. Like Prahlad Maharaj, when he was in the womb, demigods tried to kill his mother and him also, because they were afraid that if Hiranyakashipu is such a nasty person, how would his son turn out be? So they wanted to kill him, but Narada Muni convinced the demigods that the son who is coming up will be a great Mahatma, and he also made them to do circumambulate the womb actually. So Narada Muni gave lessons to Kayadu, but actually it was taken by Prahlad for 100 years, because 100 years Hiranyakashipu went for penance, and during those years Narada Muni protected Kayadu and Prahlad. And the main idea was to give him Bhagavad Dharma, because one of the greatest success in childhood is to acquire spiritual knowledge. Kaumaram acharet pragno dharman bhagavataniha. And Prahlad's life was very successful because he got knowledge directly from a great saintly person, Narada Muni. And then he was grown up, and Hiranyakashipu came back and he put his son in the school. But he was not bewildered by this material world, because he knew what material world is. When his friends asked him to come and play, he said there's no happiness there. He understood what material life is. Sukam aindrikam daitya deha yogena dehinam sarvatra labhyate dhayavad yatha dukkam ayatmatah. He said, just like no one works to get distress, but it comes on its own accord, similarly, material happiness also comes on its own accord. So the goal is not to acquire material happiness, but he says, sukhaya dukkha mokshaya. We should sankalpo hi iha karmina. One should try to endeavor to get rid of both sukha and dukkha, free from sukha and dukkha. This is what he understood in this material world. And he kept higher goals in life. He was very fixed. Yoisatmika buddhi ekehe kurunandana. He expresses, etavan eva lokismin pumsa swartha parah smritah ekanta bhaktir govinde yatra sarvatra tadikshanam. His goals were fixed. His goals were ekanta bhaktir govinde, to serve Govinda. And yat sarvatra yat tadikshitam. Always see Govinda in every sphere of life. So this was his goal, fixed on his goal. And he also achieved the goal. He underwent the test of his faith. His own father became inimical because he was just devotee of Vishnu, Narayana, Krishna. So his test, his faith was tested. His father demanded, "You are talking like a very intelligent person. Let me see. I will kill you. I'll see where, how your protector will come and protect you." And before that, he says, If you say your protector is omnipresence, he is everywhere, then show me. Is he in his own pillar? And immediately Prahlad says, yes, a staunch faith. And another success of his life is the Lord reciprocates. Lord is not partial to anyone. Namidveshasti napriyaha. But he is reciprocating. So Prahlad had a staunch faith and he was reciprocating. And to fulfill his words of Prahlad, Satyam vidhatum nijabrutya bhashitam. Nijabrutya bhashitam. What his servant Prahlad told, he wanted to make it satyam, he wanted to make it true. Yes, I am there in the pillar also. Vyaptam cha bhuteshu akleshu chatmana. I am spread everywhere. So in that, from the pillar, adrishyata ati adbhuta rupam udvahan. Stambha sabhayam nam rugam nam manusham. There came the wonderful form which was neither a animal nor a human being. It was Narasimha who appeared. So Lord appeared and fulfilled the promise, fulfilled the words of Prahlad. And he killed Hiranyakashipu. And after that, another wonderful gift Prahlad received. That was, he got the blessings of Narasimhadev directly by when Narasimhadev put his lotus hand on the head of Prahlad Maharaj. So Pade Moolam Patitam Arbakam Vilokya Deva Kropaya Pariplutaha Uttapya Tashishni Adadhat Karambujam Kalahi Vitrasta Dhyam Kritabhyam. So very mercifully Lord Narasimhadev picked up Prahlad and he put his lotus hand on him. And immediately all fears disappeared. Not only that, satat karya karasparsha dhutakila shubham. All kinds of inauspicious things disappeared. And he got the paratma darshana, he got the highest knowledge. So this was a real success of Prahlad. So success in life is not acquiring or accumulating material positions, rather getting the blessings of Krishna. So this is real success. So that's why any activity should ultimately lead to serve the Supreme Lord. They said in Bhagavatam, Neha yat karma dharmaya na viraghaya kalpate na tirtha pada sevaya jivan api mruto hisa. Even leaving is equal to death if one's work is not guided towards dharma, and if dharma is not encouraging us to take vairagya from this material world, and if it is not encouraging to us to serve the Supreme Personality of Godhead, then leaving is as good as death. That's why the whole Vedic literature encourages us to get the highest benefit of our life, human life. But in this Kali Yuga, we are discouraged. Tatashchanu dinam dharma. Every day, dharma practices get depleted or they are destroyed. And the more adharma increases, the more dissatisfaction and distresses increase. Everyone are working for happiness, but they don't know the secret of happiness. Sukhaya karmani karoti loko. Everyone are working for sukhaya, but vindeta bhuyas tava eva dukkham. But the opposite is happening. They are getting, the more they are working, they are only getting distress. So one has to understand why this is happening, because our goal of life, or goal of life to get happiness is only attained when we satisfy Krishna. And it is wonderfully said how we can satisfy Krishna. Daya sarvabhuteshu santushtya yena kenava sarvendriyopashantya cha tushyati aso janardana. By performing three activities, we can quickly satisfy Janardana, and thus we can be satisfied. Number one, by showing compassion to all the living entities, like Narada Muni. He doesn't see if he's a thief, he's a hunter, if he's a sage, if he's a king. He preaches everyone. Show his mercy. And showing mercy means giving Krishna. Second is santushtya yena kenava. Whatever be situation, we are all satisfied. Like Pandavas. They lost everything, but they were not distressed. They were just satisfied in their situation. They acquired everything back, still they were satisfied. So this is the expected from the Lord. Then sarvendriyopa shantya. All our senses are always troubling us, but we have to pacify them. Like Ambarish Maharaj does, he very selectively performs activities which satisfies each of the senses. So thus, by doing these three activities, we can very easily satisfy Krishna Janardana. This is what Prahlad Maharaj did, and this is what he's teaching us. That's why he's one of the Mahajana. Mahajana yena gatasya panta. We have to learn the process of bhakti from the great souls who are termed as Mahajanas, and Prahlad is one of them. And Prahlad is very dear to Narasimhadev. Generally, people fear, they complain and they criticize that, oh, keeping Narasimhadev photo, especially killing Hiranyakashipu and all the bloodshed, is not auspicious. But actually, it's a most auspicious thing. And it is not fearful. Anyway, the fear, it may look very ghastly, but that is one of the rasa. Just like in cinemas, we see a hero fighting with so many goons, you know, like, and he is hurt and there's bloodshed. But that's one of the rasa. We all enjoy through rasa. The spiritual enjoyment is through rasa. And there are 12 rasas. There is Bibhatsa rasa, Bhayanak rasa, Raudra rasa. Narasimha Dev presented all these rasas. It is actually a great satisfaction for, or relishment for devotees. So Prahlad, when he saw all these things, he didn't even get a little fear. He was rather ecstatic seeing all the leela of Narasimhadev. Bhaktivinoda Thakur explains, just like a lion and its lion's cub, the lion cub doesn't fear lion. Well, any other animal may fear a lion, but cub doesn't. Similarly, Lord Narasimhadev had a lot of vatsalya bhava on Prahlad, and Prahlad was so peaceful, he felt as if he was with his own father, protecting him. So, the approach we have towards the Lord is that He is our protector, we are His eternal servant. Otherwise, we fear Lord actually. Many of them fear the Lord. That's why they don't take up Krishna consciousness, because they say, if we come to Krishna consciousness, we have to leave everything, or He'll snatch up everything. Actually, that's true. So who are guilty of material enjoyment, actually don't come to Krishna. Just like there's a policeman comes, the thief is the one who get disturbed. But a decent man, he doesn't get disturbed. So it is told in the Bhagavad Gita, Arjuna says, Tane Hrishikesha Tava Prakritya Rakshans Bhitani Dushodravanti. The demons run away, but the saintly person, sarve samasyanti So Siddha Sangha, they all pay their obeisances and worship Lord. So this is the how we can actually understand our own approach to Lord. If you feel that we are will be deprived of anything by serving the Lord, this is a Hiranyakashipu mentality. But if we are very satisfied and happy serving the Lord, that is Prahlad's mentality. So for our Gaudiya Vaishnavas, worshipping Narasingh Dev is a very important aspect in our worship system. This was introduced by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu when he was in Puri. In Puri, one of the oldest temple, even before Lord Jagannath appeared, there was Narasimha temple. And after Gundicha Marjana, cleaning the Gundicha temple, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu used to take some rest in Narasimha temple and sometime perform kirtan. That's the place where he composed this prayer which we regularly sing, which Prabhupada introduced in our regular prayers, that is Namaste Narasimhaya. This was composed personally by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So that's why it's our important prayer in our regular system. And also Bhaktivinoda Thakur, when he was describing the Navadvip Parikrama, he comes to the place of Devapalli or Narasimhapalli, where he has the direct darshan of Narasingh Dev, and where in his ecstasy he composes 5 shlokas to remove the obstacles to worship Radha Krishna. So our acharyas also are preaching this important aspect of worship of Narasimhadev. In the prayers it's very nicely told that I want to enhance my worship of Radha Krishna, and there are many obstacles like 6 enemies: the lust, anger, greed, and enviousness, and all that. E dushta hrudaya kama adi roopa chai kutinati pratishtasa satya sadarai hrudaya shodhanar krishna ravasana narasimha charin mor eto kamana. Said Lord Narasingh Dev, I want to pay at your offer my respects and worship at your lotus feet, so that my heart can be cleansed of this 6 enemies, and also some subtle anarthas like kutinati pratishtasa satya. Kutinati is fault finding, duplicity. Pratishtasa, labha puja pratishta, we are expecting lot of honor, some material possessions like that. And satya is cunningness. This cunningness amidst devotees is not is very dangerous. It leads to aparad actually. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur is praying that remove all these anarthas. Hrudaya shodhana ar krishnera vasan, so that I can develop that faith and interest to serve Krishna. So long we have our dirt in our heart, it doesn't happen. So that's why what we pray to Narasingh Dev is to remove our vignas. That's why we call him Bhakti Vigna Vinashaka Narasingh Dev. It's Bhakti Vigna Vinashaka, it's not any material vignas. We have so many activities in material life. We are not praying to remove them, we are praying to remove those which become obstacle in our progress in bhakti. So that is a mood of worshipping actually Narasingh Dev. Even in ISKCON, Prabhupada introduced, when there were lot of problems in the progressive march of this movement, so he introduced twice recitation of this Manishima prayer, morning and evening. And also when there were lot of dacoits attacking Mayapur temple, at certain point when there were, it was even harming devotees, even killing devotees or causing problem to devotees, the ISKCON authorities decided to install Lord Narasingh Dev Stanu Ugra Narasimha. That's a whole big pastime. And ever since the Narasimha deity was installed, there were no more attacks, and even if there, it was like very minimal. So we can personally see in lives of many devotees their own personal realization, how Narasingh Dev influenced them and how he protected his devotees. So it's His Grace Jannivas Prabhu, the temple head pujari of Mayapur ISKCON. He tells that Prabhupada told him personally, what is the prayer we have to do to Narasimhadev? What is the mood? Basically, we should pray for the Guru's health. Secondly, for the progressive expansion of this movement, Hare Krishna movement, ISKCON movement, and to help others, devotees' obstacles, and finally our own self obstacles in bhakti. So this is how we can meditate and on this auspicious appearance day of Narasimhadev, and be inspired by, seek inspiration from Prahlad, and also learn lessons from Hiranyakashipu's pursuits, and aspire to always serve Narasimhadev. Hare Krishna. Jai Narasimhadev Bhagwan ki jai. Srila Prabhupada ki jai.